Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, everybody, and welcome back to Change of Heart. Today's story, although short, teaches us a really valuable lesson about the etiquette of repentance, especially when a person has that moment that changes their heart. There's a story that's mentioned in the books of repentance about a person named Habib ibn Muhammad, and he lived in the time of the great scholar Hasan Al Basri, rahimahullah. Hasan Al Basri one time was giving a lecture, a sermon or a khutbah, and Habib had attended that lecture. And in the lecture, he heard something that really resonated with him. And you know, all of us can probably relate to this at some point. We've been to some lecture, some gathering. For me, it was like every single lecture that Imam Siraj Wahaj, may Allah protect him, every lecture he gave. You know, there's just certain moments that you can remember when you were in a talk or a gathering, when the speaker said something that was so powerful and it just rattled your heart, just resonated with you. And so this happened to Habib. He was listening to Al-Hasan al-Basri, and Al-Hasan al-Basri said something beautiful and it resonated with Habib. And the beautiful thing about the story is that we don't even know exactly what it is that he said. All we know is that he said something that really impacted him. And so he decided at that moment that, you know what, I'm not going to let this feeling that I have, I'm not going to let this moment of realization, I'm not going to let it go to waste. Right? And this is a trend that we've been seeing from all the stories of changing of hearts, that when Allah Ta'ala gives you that moment of guidance, when Allah Ta'ala opens that door for you, right? Sharah as-sadr, they call it, like when Allah Ta'ala opens your chest, well, like when you have that moment of just realization, don't let it go to waste, because you never know when or if it'll ever come back. So he decided at that moment, you know what? I'm going to change my life. This is it. That was exactly what I needed to hear. And this is the way that I want to live my life now for the rest of my life. I don't want to be a person that disobeys Allah. I want to try my best to get close to Him as much as possible. And so a lot of us kind of, we get to that point, and then the next question is, well, what do I do now? What do I do next? Is it just a matter simply of, you know, repenting and going back to Allah and changing my ways? Yeah, actually it is. It is that simple. But there are some things that you can do and that, you know, anybody would do in any relationship to try to emphasize the moments of repentance. You know, if you make somebody upset, if you make your spouse upset or your parents upset or your friends upset, and you apologize and you change your way, that's good, right? That's enough. But you always go out of your way to kind of like maybe send them some cookies or flowers, or, you know, go visit them or call them more. Why? Because you know that the action that you do is going to speak louder than your words. What you do is going to speak louder than what you have to say. So Habib ibn Muhammad, he also understood this, and he knew that making tawbah to Allah, Allah Ta'ala accepts all tawbah. But I want to show Allah that I'm serious. I want to show Allah that I'm for real. That is, you know, I've said astaghfirullah before. I've said, oh Allah, forgive me before, as we all have in du'as and Ramadan and maybe gone for Umrah or Hajj. But I want to show Allah that I am legit. And so what did he do? And I don't recommend this for everybody, but what did he do? He gave 10,000 dinar away. He gave 10,000 gold coins away in sadaqah. And when he gave them away, he gave it away with the intention that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive him as a result of the sadaqah. And then he felt grateful that Allah ta'ala had guided him. And so as a token of his gratitude to Allah, his shukr, he gave another 10,000 away. And then he was walking along and he said, you know what? I hope Allah actually accepted my tawbah. I hope my tawbah wasn't just like surface level. I hope Allah accepted it. And so he gave another 10,000. He said, oh Allah, if you didn't accept my tawbah or the charity that I've given, this is another sadaqah in hopes that you will accept everything that I've done. And then he felt good in his heart and he went about his day, and then it was nighttime and he said to himself, alhamdulillah, you know, I had a good day. I changed my life, I changed my ways. I gave charity today, I gave a lot of charity today, alhamdulillah. I'm just so grateful to Allah that he accepted my tawbah. I'm so grateful to Allah that he guided me. And then so he said, you know what? I'm gonna give another 10,000 because this is for me to thank Allah for accepting my tawbah and for granting me the ability to give charity and doing all these good deeds. What's the powerful lesson here? Number one is what we mentioned, which is when the realization happens, you have to capitalize. Number two is that when you wanna seek repentance from Allah, make istighfar, turn back to Allah. Go to the prayer rug, pray two raka'at. The Prophet ﷺ said that when a person, when they make wudu and they stand and they pray and they seek repentance from Allah, then Allah will forgive them, He'll purify their hearts. but also add in some action that you're going to do with the intention of seeking forgiveness from Allah. And charity is a really, really good action because there is a Quranic evidence as to how charity is one of the deeds in which Allah Ta'ala has ordained as being an eraser of sins. You know, not all deeds necessarily will erase sins, right? Not all good deeds will do that. If I hold open the door for somebody, that's a nice deed, but there's nothing inherent about that deed that'll erase maybe a sin that I've done. But there are some deeds that will erase sins, that the more that we do them, the more that Allah Ta'ala forgives us. And so one of those deeds is sadaqah, and in Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 271, when Allah Ta'ala is describing sadaqah, and He's describing the people who give sadaqah, He says, إِن تُبُدُوا الصَّدَقَاتِ فَنِعِمَّا هِيَ. He says that if you disclose, if you decide to disclose the charity that you give, He said that that's okay, that's good, it's not a problem, right? As long as the person's not doing it to show off. If a person has to disclose it for some reason, then that's fine. You know, tell their family, tell their business partners, etc., right? But He says, وَإِن تُخْفُوهَا, right? وَتُؤْتُوهَا الْفُقَرَاءَ فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. That, but if you do keep it really secret, and if you do hide it, and if you give to those who are in need, then that is actually better for you. That is like the best case scenario. You give charity to those who are in need, and you hide what you've given, right? Now here's the kicker. وَيُكَفِّرُ عَنْكُمْ مِنْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ مِنْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ. Allah Ta'ala says that, and as a result of this deed of charity in private, Allah Ta'ala will expiate and expunge from your sins, that your sins will start to disappear. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. And Allah Ta'ala is aware of everything that you do, right? Allah Ta'ala is always aware of everything, right? So subhanAllah, the reality is that when we turn back to Allah, Allah is so merciful and so forgiving that we can bet, we can walk away with certainty knowing that Allah will forgive us. But it more so speaks to who we are that we want to do something extra. And Habib ibn Muhammad gave 40,000 gold coins that day, and we may not have that kind of wealth. But ask yourself, what would you be willing to give a sadaqah if it meant that Allah Ta'ala would forgive you for that sin or those sins or that lifestyle? What would you be willing to give? Would you be willing to give $100, $1,000? What would you be willing to give to show Allah that you're for real? Because as they say, right, we got to make sure that money does the talking, right? Allah Ta'ala knows that we love money. Allah Ta'ala knows. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. He told us this. You love money with this crazy amount of love, right? So what's the best way to show somebody that you love them more than something that they know you love? Is to give what you love for them. That's the best way to show them. If I know that you love something and you want to show me you love me, then you sacrifice what I know you love for me. Because why? That proves that you love me more than the thing that you had in your heart. Allah knows that money is in our heart. Allah knows that we love payday, we love shopping, we love getting new things. What's the best way to show Allah that we love Him more? Giving charity for His sake. Oh Allah, You gave me this wealth and I love it. But Allah, I don't love this wealth more than I love You. I love You so much more than everything You've given me. And I'm going to prove it to You by giving it away for a good cause, in a good way. But I'm going to give that wealth away to show You, Ya Allah, that I'm serious, right? The story of Ka'b ibn Malik that we talked about earlier as well, he ends the story by telling the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or the story ends by him telling the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that as a way for me to thank Allah for this forgiveness, I'm going to give away all my wealth. I'm going to give away everything. And the Prophet ﷺ says, don't give away all of it. Keep some, right? So Islam is not about being extreme. It's not about making you do things in extreme ways. But it is about proving your love for Allah and sincerely showing it. We ask Allah Ta'ala to give us that sincerity. We ask Allah Ta'ala to give us the strength and the ability to prove as sadaqah that charity is real within us and that we ask Allah Ta'ala to forgive us for our sins. Barakallahu feekum, everybody. We'll see you inshallah tomorrow. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.